Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to demonstrate you the use of rewind function available in file handling in C programming. Before starting, you can note how you can search my YouTube channel. You can type my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube search. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos here. Now I am going to implement solution of this problem. So I am including two header files, stdio.h and stdlib.h. Now I am going to define main function. Inside main function, I am declaring a file pointer, then a character array and character variable ch. Now I am going to open a file. Name of file is string.txt, and I am opening this file in W plus mode. So W plus mode is a mode which provides you the facility for reading and writing. So if you are opening a file in W plus mode, it means you can read the content which are available in a file, as well as you can write contents into a file. And if string.txt is not available, this W plus mode will create this file automatically. Now I have to check whether this file is opened successfully or not. So I am applying this if condition, which will display an error message that is cannot open file, and then exit. This will terminate execution of the program. So if this condition is false, then the remaining statements which are which will be implemented after this if condition will be executed. So now I am going to write a printf which will display enter a line of text. So this message will be displayed on output screen, and that line of text will be received through getS into str. I am increasing this size to 50. Now I have to store this line of text into a file. So I am calling fputs. I am passing two arguments into it, str and fp. So fputs writes strings into file. So this str will be stored inside fp file pointer. So after this writing operation, file pointer will move to the end of file. Now I am going to read this file again, that is pointed through fp. So file pointer is on end of file, but I want to read the file from the beginning. So for that purpose, I am going to call rewind function. So rewind function brings the file pointer at the beginning of file. So if you want to move your file pointer from ending to the beginning of the file, then you can call rewind function, and you can pass file pointer in it. So after calling fputs, file pointer will be moved to end of file, but rewind will bring that file pointer at the beginning of the file. Now without closing and reopening this file, I can read the contents which are available in the file from the beginning. So I have written a line of text into a file, then I have called rewind function. So right now file pointer is at the beginning of the file. So now I am applying a while loop which will read the contents from the file. So here I am calling fgetc function, which will read a character from file. Now I am checking whether this character is at equals to end of file or not. So if it is equals to end of file, then I can break the loop. Otherwise I can print the content on output screen with the help of printf. So this way, through this loop, I am going to read the contents which are available in the file, and those contents will be displayed on output screen. After this, I can close the file, and then I am writing return 0. So this way I have implemented the rewind function in front of you. In this program, I am writing the data first into a file, and then I am reading the entered data back, and I am going to display that data on output screen. And for that purpose, for reading writing purpose, I have used W plus mode. Now I am going to execute this code. It is asking for a line of text, so I am entering My name is Sanjay Gupta. I live in India. So this text will be stored inside the file. So I am pressing enter key. That text has shifted to file, and you can see it is displaying again on output screen because I am reading the content which is stored inside file with help of fgetc function. So this getS function is reading the content, then fputs is writing that content into the file, then rewind is bringing back file pointer at the beginning of file, and through this loop I am reading the contents of file and those contents are displayed on output screen. Now I have to check the contents of string.txt. So this source code is stored in ctcn bin folder with name test.c. So this string.txt is created on that file, on that location. So I am opening ctcn bin folder. Here I have to press s so that I can search the files starting with the name s. Here you can see string.txt is available. I am opening this file. You can see the content. It is having the content. My name is Sanjay Gupta. I live in India. So this is the text which I have entered on output screen. It is available in this file. That's why this text is displayed again on output screen through this program. So this way I have demonstrated you the use of rewind function with the help of W plus mode. I hope you have understood how we can use rewind function in file handling in C programming. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can search my name Sanjay Gupta in YouTube. My channel will be available there. You can watch various programming related videos there. Thank you for watching this video.